And this is the part of the class when we're going to talk about our dynamic elements. The elements we've looked at so far are the trends, these bar graphs here, the multi-state symbols that change color, and also these values here. What we haven't looked at yet is the XY plot. We'll look at that. The best place to start with this is to look at the data favorites pane. This is a relatively new feature, and you need to have some display open in order to see this. I'm just going to open up the display from our first exercise. And you also need to be in a build mode to see this. If you notice in the view menu, we do not see the data favorites pane until we get into build menu because it's primarily used for building displays. So go into build view or build mode, choose view, data favorites. What you'll see is it's a nice little widget here that allows us to drag and drop items onto the screen, and then what we drop onto the screen ends up being generated as one of those dynamic objects. So for example, I'm defaulting right now so that it will create a brand new value object, and we can change what that default is. So let's clear this out before we do anything else. I'm going to remove everything from our data favorites. Oops. And let's look at how we would create this. Now, first of all, there's two parts of this data favorites. You'll notice there's a search window. There's the search window by itself. And then there's the data favorites window, which is also can be shown by itself. And the idea is you type in some kind of search criteria in the search screen. Like, for example, I'll type in CDT, which is the first three characters in the name of a tag I use all the time in training, CDT158. Once you've found that tag, you can either just drag it over, we can do a right mouse click, choose Add to Favorites, and then it becomes part of your data favorites. At that point, if you want to, you can just put the search away. You can then use the data favorites to go ahead and drag this over, drop it onto the screen. Admittedly, that doesn't seem very impressive when you're just doing it one tag at a time. The real power of this, of course, is that all those things that you tend to use a lot are very useful if you've got them stored in a data favorite. So I can choose CD with CD asterisk. And let me go ahead and bring these others too as well. We use this in training as well. So what I'd like to do, I've got two more that I'm interested in moving, so I'll select both of them. I'll click and drag them over so that now they become part of my data favorites. I also use the tags that begin with SINU, the sinusoid tags. These may seem familiar from some of our earlier work. Now I've dragged them over, they're part of my data favorites. Now, in addition to searching this way, I can also search using this tag search dialog, the same tag search dialog we've seen before. And so, for example, there's a series of tags that begin with the letters BA that I like to use a great deal. We find these with all of our Pi servers. We ship them with each Pi server. And we'll go for level, concentration, and temperature. I'll select those. And now I can add those as data favorites. Do a right mouse click, choose Add to Favorites. Now we've got these all here. So the power of this now is I'm done with the search engine. I've got my favorites the way I want them. And now I can put these anywhere I need to put these. So for example, in the case of my first exercise, we're going to say CDT158. That in fact represents the value of this flow. So I'll go ahead and put that over there. Sinusoid represents the level of this tank, so I'll go ahead and put that over there. And let's say this represents the temperature in that tank, so I'll put that right there. You get the picture. What we're doing here is we're simply selecting what we need and putting it, in the right place. Now, I've just been by default dragging these values over. And let's just make sure that we know the names of these values. I put the values, the names at the bottom of all of these. We're going to cover later on how to change the defaults. But we can see now, this is BA temp, that's sinusoid, that's CDT158. Let's say that for each one of these, I also wanted to put a bar graph. Well, no problem. What I can do is just change the default. And this is where you would go and change that default. Right now, it's defaulting to value, which is in bold. I'll just change that to bar, and let's do this one at a time. So BA temp, which is right here, I'll just click and drag this over, And now I've got a bar chart for that BATemp.1. So now I've got a bar graph that will default. Let's do the same for sinusoid. Let's make this a little bit bigger. Here's sinusoid, and that represents, or it's been represented as a value. Now we'll represent it as a value and a bar graph. Just put that right next to it. And then finally CDT158. So I could do this with any of the, the primitives or the basic objects, the dynamic objects. So here's CDT158 represented that way. And perhaps this is obvious already, but if I go back here and do a trend, now we'll do exactly the same thing. And of course I can do this in any order I want. I grab this, drag it over, and now it becomes a trend. A trend far too big for this particular graphic, so I'll go ahead and clean it up there. But as you can see, with the power of data favorites is once you, if you're going to be building a lot of these things for these different objects, it's very nice to have all your favorite things here so that you can simply drag and drop, drag these things over, drop them on the page, and then they become the objects that you were after. Now, one last feature that we haven't explored yet is what happens if you choose two things at once, if you choose two of these and then generate a trend or more. Well, as you can see, when I do that, it's simply going to go ahead and build as many traces onto that trend as what you've selected. Again, let me demonstrate that again. I can pick any of these and just drag them over. And what you'll notice is it builds a trend that has multiple values on it. And you can always add more. So if I decide, hey, I wanted to look at this as well, just drag that over on top. That becomes a new object on that display. So any of these things that I need, I can go ahead and add to that display. There we go. Just keep dragging them over. I'll show you something I find particularly compelling is with the XY plot, if you choose XY plot as the default, well, what you've got now here is a very nice little correlation engine. I can say, well, let's see if there's a relation between level and temperature or level and anything on here. And if I click, bring that over, we immediately now have an XY plot that shows me, well, in this case, there is a fairly strong correlation, a coefficient of correlation of 0.87, which, that's of extremely high correlation. The point is, you can do this to any of these things. Let's compare concentration to temperature, drag this over. It's a fairly strong inverse correlation. Yeah, that one's strongly correlated as well. Well, in any case, the whole idea now is you've got this wonderful little engine. You can look at all your different favorites, and whatever else you can search for, and just immediately kind of drop XY plots to show you if there are any correlations between those process values that you may not be aware of already.